Hey guys, it's me, Catherine Chloe Cahoon. Here's some footage from a photo shoot for my new website. As you can see, my dad got roped into taking the picture. And during the shoot, the real tagger showed up. They take pride in their work and pointed out a few problems. I was holding my spray can wrong and using the wrong color, so they loaned me one of their cans and showed me how to use it. For this shot, I wanted a pompadour hairstyle. It's been very hot with celebrities, and each one puts her own twist on the look. So I studied their pictures and devised my own variation with the help of my friend Molly. She's an award-winning colorist who trains hairstylists. In other words, she's a hair queen. Molly said that the first step in creating a perfect pompadour is to use a curling iron. This gives your hair body. Start at the base of your head and work up to your hairline. Then if you use small clips to hold the curls in place, that will help them set. The second step is to tease the top third of your hair like crazy. Use a strong holding hairspray like aerogel. You really can't over tease. At this point, if you look like there's a rat's nest sitting on top of your head, you've done it right. Next, pull the smooth, non-teased section of your hair into a low ponytail. I wanted to have mine slightly to one side so that it showed from the front. The fourth step is to gently smooth your back combed hair without ruining the volume. Then bobby pin the pompadour into place, but leave out a hunk of hair on one side, starting at your part line. Next, either braid or twist the hair at the base of the pompadour. Just get creative. Play around with any kind of braid or twist you like. Then wrap it around the elastic, holding your ponytail, and pin it in place. The last step is to take that remaining chunk of hair along your part line, swoop it back, and pin it into the base of your pompadour. Voila! You are ready to rock this look, and it only took 6 easy steps. Thank you so much, Molly.